Let's talk about the game's namesake before we get into the actual games. So as it turns out, the Metroid is the most horrifying creature under any sun. First off, they float, but they don't have wings or emit any kind of energy. Dick my butt, how do they float? Secondly, the only way to kill these things is with either extreme cold or with a severe ass whooping. And I mean severe.
But that boy is gonna get a whooping anyway.
Third, and most horrifying of all, is that they feed off an unknown energy that they draw in an unknown manner from living creatures. Plain and simple, the Metroid is stealing souls. It is an evil floating space alien thing that eats your soul. It's eating souls, don't you get it? It takes your soul!
Your soul is mine.
No, it isn't.
Shopping?
Yeah, I'm a pillar of female individuality and health work, so no.
I'm so drunk I might go home with a grenade tonight.
Female action heroes aren't that uncommon these days, but back in the late 80s, it was pretty rare. How freaking cool was it when you beat Metroid, thinking the whole time that you're some badass space marine just strutting around smoking cigars and pounding space hookers? And then you find out, in a total Bruce Willis was dead the whole time at the end of the Sixth Sense kind of way, that you were a hot chick.
What a twist!
Nintendo was trolling me from the start button. Samus is still a character that embodies female individuality, an archetype for future lady heroines like Lara Croft, or future ladies on heroin, like Amy Winehouse.
Oh my god. I think that guy is checking you out.
Baby, you must be from outer space, because I can see the stars in your eyes.
Please go away, before I leave.
Gee, what a bitch! You must be on the rag! How about you?
Shit, I'll switch a Metroid!
Metroid was always sweet, way back from the beginning. But when the franchise made the shift into polygons, it didn't just take the Mario and Zelda approach by becoming a reinvented 3D version. The game also changed genres from exploration platformer to exploration shooter. Metroid Prime was fan-fucking-tastic! My first game on the GameCube. I couldn't get enough. I felt like I was the one in the power suit. I mean, everything from the data logs to the intense combat that had me fighting for my life against Meta Ridley and space pirates with a plasma cap right in their stupid asses. If you love this game, give me a hell yeah!
Hey, remember how stoked every one of us was when Nintendo aired the trailer by Team Ninja for Metroid Other M? I know, we all were. But when it came out, this game made Samus into an intolerable twat. What happened to the hardened heroine of the universe? Turned into a retarded half-drunk bimbo that Snooki could replace. Even in a life and death situation, she won't use her powers because her commander won't let her? That's your excuse for no power up? Are you kidding me? If she will sit there and die on some other guy's orders, I wonder what else he could have gotten her to do.
So there you have it, guys. There are some of the awesome things that we have to say about Metroid.
Do you think that maybe this franchise was also kind of inspired by the Alien franchise? You have a character named Ridley, you have a strong female protagonist, it takes place in space?
Yeah, like there's always the possibility or something like that. I believe that's like, you know, one of the popular rumors about the franchise.
I think the other thing is just that she's hot. I mean,
yeah.
He's dead.
Putting aside those guys, the franchise has plenty of other games that we haven't talked about, including like Metroid Fusion, which was a phenomenal game that I've personally been waiting for a sequel to that for the longest time. It was an amazing, brand new side-scrolling platformer. You know, if you want to see another side-scrolling Metroid game, post down below.
And our friend is dead, and we're just all enablers.
You think we can get kids to hit him with bats?
Ooh.
Let's go.
Let's go.